Hello everybody, I'm going to be a bad guy today. I heard a lot of inspiring speeches yesterday and today, and I really appreciate it. But my problem is, while attending this kind of event, which is very helpful, which gives me a lot of things, of course, and the audience, attending to this award ceremonies in the field of advertising, I'm getting inspired, I'm getting excited, but when I go back to my home and switch the TV on, I see all the shitty commercials that annoys me so much. I see all these ugly billboards in the street, and kind of when I go back to the reality, I understand how not really exciting advertising is. So that's my introduction. That's me. That's my webpage. If you're interested, you can go there and see what I've done the last 10 years. Not of course, all of it, but just a couple of projects what I'm less embarrassed to show to the audience. This is the agencies and design studios where I had a chance to work or intern. That's the awards that I managed, my projects managed to gain during my career. And why I make such a big introduction of myself, showing the awards and stuff, because for the people who doesn't know me, I really want to make sure that I'm worth listening, because as I said, I'm going to be a bad guy today and say a lot of bad things. That's my dog, Dora, and that's the logo for my startup, what I'm doing now with two of my friends. It's called Dora's Lab. We're doing mobile applications and games. Yeah. Which means I quit advertising a couple of months ago. It doesn't mean I quit and I don't have anything in common with advertising. Probably my life is kind of locked with a deadlock with advertising somehow, but I'm not doing it professionally. I'm not working in agencies anymore, and I don't like to. Yeah, and that's the title of my speech on future Georgia, and title is, there might be no future. And why is that? Why I think so? Because I'll try to analyze the whole situation. Advertising industry more or less contains with these three groups of people. It's client. And I'm putting all the marketing guys over there, creatives who are actually creating the final outcome of what you see out there, and the consumer for whom everything is made for. Let's start with creatives. I've been there for 10, 15 years. All these years, I was in that group of people, and I'm still there. And yeah, it's not a good situation there. People are desperate, people are not really happy about what they're doing. Day before yesterday, it's the right word, I asked my colleagues from all over the world one question: how you feel about advertising? I swear to God, I didn't give any hint what if it's a negative context or positive. I just asked this question. And ask to be precise, just say one sentence, how they feel about advertising. So here we go. Love and hate relationship, says Michelle, copywriter from Paris. Not harsh enough, I think. Advertising comforts you warmly and wins you off from achieving your dreams, says Maximilian, art director from Hamburg. The word whore comes to my mind, says Trim, art director from Oslo. A fucked up shortcut to influence, Mark, art director from Berlin. Yeah, that's a funny video. It doesn't say anything, but it's funny to watch.
See, in this world, there's two kinds of people, my friend. Those with loaded guns
That was Chris, operator from Berlin. And last but not least, an easy way to get money and lose your soul, says Juarez, our director from Hamburg. So, of course, these particular messages, they don't cover the whole industry, but I do believe it kind of pictures the overall situation. The overall situation, how creative persons, they feel in this industry. And while thinking about this, why it's happening, why we're not so happy, why we are so bored being in this, having this dream job where we thought about. And the main reason, not to go into very precise details, the main reason I think is that we are not really interested in final outcome for what we are working. We're not interested in how many burgers will McDonald's sell. We're not interested in how many bottles will Coca-Cola sell. We just don't care. We're there because we're obsessed. Because we have this energy inside us, the creative energy, where we just are willing to spend. And sometimes we don't even care if it's a good outcome or not. We just need to get rid of it. And that's the main reason we are in advertising. But for example, I'm always bringing the example of almost all the professions, like doctors, for example. If you ask a young girl why you want to be a doctor, she's gonna say, because I want to save people's lives, because I want to take care of their health. So she's interested in the final outcome. Nobody would say, because I want to cut their muscles and go inside. Of course not, right? They're interested in final outcome. Architect wants to build a house. I don't know, constructor wants to build a bridge. But we creative people, and actually the biggest drive of advertising industry, maybe I'm exaggerating a bit, but we just don't care about the final outcome. But on the other hand, client cares a lot. And that's exactly what they're the only thing they care about. They don't care about how you realize yourself, how beautifully crafted your work is, but they care about how many bottles they're gonna sell. And unfortunately, in most cases, the only method they think that's gonna make more bottles sell is to make their logo bigger. Of course, it's a metaphor of being not qualified, cutting your legs off in this creative process just to be sure that they're gonna sell more burgers. So all this combination results, sums up to this ugliness. Ugliness which pollutes the whole world. And it's not Georgia's problem, even though I think it's a kind of a bit worse situation here than, for example, in Germany. But still, even in Germany, the billboards you see out there, the commercials you see there, and the campaigns, the whole campaigns, they're not really good. 90% of all these commercials and all this advertising, it's pollution, it's ugly, disgusting, and people are annoyed, people don't like us. You're not gonna see this picture in the real world, right? Hey, advertising has started. Did you see this YouTube 5-second ad? No, it's not real. They hate it. They hate what we're doing. I was living in Germany for 2 years, and these stickers are very popular there. It says, please, no advertising. And they just put these stickers all over their post boxes because they don't want to see it. What's the solution? I don't have any. If I would have, probably I would stay in advertising. But I don't have the solution. I don't see how it's gonna change. Therefore, I'm heading myself to other direction. And hopefully someday it will all work out well. But I would finish my small depressing speech with a quote from Rob Campbell from Wyden Kennedy. He speaks about advertising in future. I'm just going to read it for you. Advertising in 2012 will be similar to advertising today, except we will be more frustrated from 8 additional years of false claims and promises from industry visionaries. The future is not a predetermined place. It can only happen if we push, provoke, create, and prove ourselves over and over again. So hopefully in future, we push this industry in the right direction. Otherwise, there is no happy ending, there is no future. Thank you.
Any question?
Why so serious?
Yuri, thanks very much. And how do you think about getting an advertisement as a product? So how do you sell your own product as an advertiser?
How I sell my product?
Because you really give a fuck about your product.
I do. How I sell it, if I think back, my only method was to be in love with my ideas, with my product. To be in love meaning to take care of it, to really be passionate about it, to put an effort in it. And I think what always worked was this, my own trust, what client would see. If they would see I trust in my product, that was more likely that they would buy it. Probably that was kind of my only method, to really trust in what I was selling, which doesn't mean I always trusted in what I was selling. But in these cases, it was more hard to sell something because, like, not always you have the idea what you love, what you believe in. But if I had one, I would sell it. I would sell it for sure. More questions, please.
Thank you very much.
You were talking about that advertisement doesn't have feature and it's pretty annoying and so on and so on. Don't you think that, let's like talk about one brand, so like Apple. Don't you think that the logo, the branding, and the whole thing that Apple represents is not something that annoys people?
Mm-hmm.
And what can you say about it? So there is one side, the dark side, and the light side, so.
Yeah, I was ready for that. The thing is, the first thing is, I don't remember a lot of pollution in terms of Apple's communication. We know all this. We all know this 1984 commercial, which was just shown for once on air. We just remember a couple of this. What is kind of mainstream typical advertising, right? So they didn't really pollute environment with the communication. They put effort in product, on the contrary. But generally speaking, about dark side and the light side, the problem is, of course, I have goosebumps when I see great commercial. I love it. I love this spirit. That's why I spent 15 years there. But the problem is, if we bring again example of medicine generally, right? If we see, medicine, like medicine is the right word, medicina?
Medicine,
right? If we say, a lot of people are dying, but we save this guy. You know, it's good. It's not a good picture. If the field is responsible for saving lives, it should save everybody's life. There should be at least more light side in this industry rather the dark side. But as I said, unfortunately, beyond this kind of events, beyond the awards and this unfortunately, a lot of fake projects on these awards. Beyond this, what we see in real life, it's ugly, it's annoying, it's disturbing, it's pollution. And that should be a problem. There are questions? Can they ask more questions, or are we done?
Any more questions?
That was mine. Well, about the pollution of the advertisements.
Well, as we all know that clients usually ask for a shitty product. I mean, when you're working in agency, you're working hard, but most of the projects you work for are sometimes not as good as you want them to be. So the clients want their logo to be big, right? So how do you do this? I mean, of course you want to have a good crafted advertisements in the field, but the clients are asking not that good crafted advertisements, so you should find the middle. So on this project, should you proceed and get the money for the not very good project, or you should like skip it and say, no, okay, I'm not doing this because this is polluting the environment?
The problem is, I'll try to answer shortly. The problem, what you mentioned, like client asking for a bad job, is a local problem mostly. It's mostly about Georgian clients, unfortunately. In the developed markets, what I experienced, it's not like this. They want crappy work. They want beautiful advertising and what makes people happy. But the problem, what I try to raise today and bring the arguments, it's beyond bad client, good creative. It's beyond that. And the problem, as I state, I think is in the system itself. Because you have this group of people, creative guys, and they care about different thing, and you have a client with different mission and reasons to have relationship with creative people, and consumers who are just suffering from this mismatch, what is in between creatives and clients. And it's, again, it's not only good creative guy willing to do something great and client saying, no, I don't want something great. No, I think it's a sickness generally of the system, how it exists today. And I'm not saying advertising is over. It's transforming, it's gonna transform into something else, but as I said, we have to analyze what's the situation today to transform it into something better.
One first.
Thank you for the inspiring speech. I've got one question. Don't you think that advertising companies create the value for the society?
Creating what?
Creating the value for the society.
Value.
Yeah.
Even if they do, it's more exception than the rule. I think porn industry made more benefit for society than advertising. Literally, like not like because we watch it, but they developed a lot of technologies. You can count these technologies on your finger, but what advertising did? I mean, it helped to sell more products, and maybe it's doing something. But as I said, if you have a particular case, and I've seen it, of course, where advertising does something good, it's more exception, it's more particular cases than speaking generally about the industry. What you can't say about the porn industry, for example.
Next question.
Yeah.
My point is saying, actually, I think that. I agree that nobody cares about advertising. Nobody loves the job. Unless it creates value. I mean, benefits in someone, upgrading life, making someone's life comfortable. And if we have the situation when we creatives work on projects that brings upgrade or values or just happiness, we use our creative energy. Yeah. You're happy. We don't care about selling bottles, but we care to make someone comfortable sleep.
Yeah.
And the brand on the other side cares about this.
Probably
Google or.
Probably that's, I agree, that's kind of a light in the end of the tunnel in that direction, if there is any. Where creative mind and business mind, they gather for something good. But again, I'm saying it, we have to face the reality, and reality is out there, in the streets, in internet, on our TV. Reality is that there, not in Cannes Lions event. That's what I'm trying to state. Yeah, of course, like directions what you mentioned, that's probably where it should go, but it should go there. And to go there, we have to change something. We have to realize that this is the situation today.
Yeah.
We should go there.
So what's the point of quitting? You are talking a lot about changing something and you decide to quit. So who will be the next guy who will change everything? I just don't get the point of quitting.
Okay.
If you are so interested in this business, if you are so inspired, if it bothers you so much, because I don't give a fuck about it at all, but now I'm listening to you and thinking, this guy has the really arguments, now I'm gonna go with them and do some really good commercial because it's cheap. So maybe don't quit.
Yeah,
and you just grab your balls and start doing stuff that should be done. I think it will be more good for you and for the business.
Thank you for saying that. About my decision to quit. This is the particular case. It happened so that I was in advertising for so many years, but I never ever was really in love with advertising. My ideal career is a career of an artist. When I'm making a movie, when I'm making a photo shooting, when I'm illustrating, this is my dream job. And advertising for me was always a source to not think about what to eat. And today, I quit because obviously I'm not a visionary who can really change something, otherwise I would not quit. And I'm just deciding to replace this routine for me with some other routine, which is mobile applications. If it works for me, I'm more happy, because particularly in this case, I don't have client there, I don't depend much on the local economy, and it's kind of a source for me, good source, if it works. We've been working on it for a year and a half, and I've earned not a penny from that business. But if it works out well, I will be happy, because I'm not gonna think about what to eat, and I will be more free to do my art projects. And hopefully, these art projects will be also somehow connected to advertising. And hopefully, these projects will put some value in industry in general and make it better. That's the only thing I can do for advertising today, unfortunately.
One last question.
Thank you. I want to ask a question, but before the question, I want to thank you for just beautiful presentation, and not only for a presentation, you actually as a creative advertiser, and not only you, but maybe there are several guys in Georgia which actually create and do this thing which personally I and others can be proud of. And I want to thank you for this also.
Appreciate it.
And, I won't believe that someone is not, if say that there is no advertisement in Georgia, I won't believe it, because there are several of them, because, which makes me happy and I get pleasure with these videos or commercials and so on. And we also with the Apple products, I, from time to time, I'm just sitting and just watching this commercial because it makes me happy, because they, because of the, I hate their product, but I love their commercials. I see it like a movie, and it's very fun, but I see it like a movie and watch their commercials, how they're just show and the colorful ideas inspire you and so on. And my main question is about you, about your new direction in the gaming and the application field. Can you say in brief what are you doing right now and what your plans in Dora study more?
Yeah, it's two applications we have published. It's one is Captune, which is a simple idea. If you are familiar with the Vine application, it works in the same way. So you have a recorder, a screen, and you press and records, release its pauses, but instead of empty 7 seconds, you can keep the music from your library. So your music is your timeline. You press it, music plays, recording plays, you release, they both stop, and you can continue later, which means when you're done, without any editing, when you press done, you have edited, tuned up music video. That's the first caption. And the second one is a dummy game, which is, I think, beautiful. It looks beautiful. There's a bird who is pooing over the bad guys' heads. And that's how you fly, you have to poo. And it pulls on the lumberjack, hunter, businessman, I'm businessman in the bad point of view, pirates and stuff. And also, like, if you pull on the cutting tree, the tree grows up. So it's a dummy one-touch game, but it's beautifully done, and we really put a lot of time and effort in that. That's the two things we have already published, but there are two other games coming, and hopefully, like, we're not going deep and like complicated. We're doing just simple stuff just to raise some funds to finance our startup, because today, as I said, we're not earning anything. So that's exactly what we're doing.
And how are you going to sell these products, your products?
Applications.
To go on scale.
Hopefully the big guy's gonna talk about us. That's the thing that works. If big guys talk about you, big guys, I mean, if Apple features you, if some blogs write about you, and you have capacity, you have capacity to keep those consumers, the players, with you for some while, and you have quite a bunch of them, then it's working. So yeah, I mean, we're trying too hard to make the products good enough, and then to make the right guys to talk about us.
You're not going to make pop-up advertising on YouTube or?
I don't know. Actually, I'm not really informed how it works. In games, for example, now a big publisher is going to publish this bird game. He's in 1 week or so, he's going to publish, which means he's going to do all the job. We're going to be just developers in that, and we'll give the share to these guys, and he's going to do everything because he's good at that. We're not really experienced in publishing. So I don't know what kind of mechanics they're going to use.
Thank you for the great presentation, and just one question. What if your product, you love it, you've done it, and maybe Apple or someone big will buy it to start up and then advertise in this type, just online, what then?
You care about the bubbles or you care about it?
I care about, in this particular case, I cared about creating this game mostly. Like that's my kind of, in this scale. My goal is to was to create this game. If somebody will use advertising, what I'm kind of going against, that was the question, right? For, to sell this game,
yeah.
What I think about it, that's the question.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that because I don't know the English word for that, but I'm not an obsessed freak who is like against something and I kind of pray and swear God that I'm not going to. No, I'm following the wave. I've been thinking about this for many years, but I was still in advertising because I don't think going against and crashing your head against the concrete wall is the right thing to do. I'm trying to follow everything. I'm trying to benefit from whatever is around. And if I can do something, if I can say something what I don't like, I'm doing that. I'm honest. But it's not like I have this rules that I don't like it. That's why I'm not going to use it. No.
Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for the question. Thank you.